The Tesla Marconi system was forever abandoned.
Many people have sacrificed their liberties. Poverty and tyranny are their reward. Fellow citizens, all peoples are free to govern themselves as they see fit and to achieve a decent and satisfying life. A just and lasting peace based on genuine agreement freely arrived at by equals. In the pursuit of these aims, people find themselves directly opposed by the United States and other like-minded nations. A regime with contrary aims and a totally different concept of life. That regime adheres to a false philosophy which purports to offer freedom, security, and greater opportunity. Many peoples have sacrificed their liberties in the pursuit of these aims. People find themselves directly opposed.
Free communications was not in the plan. Marconi stations such as KPH in Bolinas, California were seized and RCA took over and eliminated the Marconi system, fashioned on Tesla's ideas. Following RCA's formation, amateur radio was restored and given the worthless frequencies above 1,500 kilocycles. Hams found that these frequencies allowed for very long distance but intermittent transmission by Hertzian means.
Democracy and freedom for all!
That regime adheres to a false philosophy. False philosophy. Misled by that philosophy, many peoples have sacrificed their liberties.
The Tesla Marconi system was forever abandoned.
The Tesla Marconi system was forever abandoned. That regime adheres to a false philosophy. Poverty and tyranny are their reward.
The Tesla Marconi system was forever abandoned. The present amateur radio has abandoned all experimentation and has embraced the corporate instituted technologies of the new Babylon. Although amateur radio has the potential for the development of the Tesla non-electromagnetic radio system, the lure of the 2-meter yak-yak renders this development unlikely. In all likelihood, Tesla's important developments are lost forever. But let's see what's going on here.
Many peoples have sacrificed their liberties. Poverty and tyranny are their reward.
False philosophy, which purports to offer freedom, security. Democracy and freedom for all!
That regime adheres to a false philosophy. That regime adheres to a false philosophy. False philosophy. False philosophy. False philosophy.
Freedom for all!
That regime adheres to a false philosophy. False philosophy.
Freedom for all! Freedom for all! Freedom for all!
False philosophy.
Freedom for all! Freedom for all! Freedom for all!
False philosophy.
The Tesla Marconi system was forever abandoned.
Poverty and tyranny are their reward.
Tesla established the system where he could transmit longitudinally through the Earth electrical power at a velocity of 291,000 miles per second. Also, he developed a beam to...
What was that speed?
291,000 miles per second, pi over 2 times the velocity of light.
186,000 miles per second is C. I think you're exceeding C. Maybe kilometers?
No, it's pi over 2 times the velocity of light.
He is exceeding C. He'll go on and explain. Okay.
There's a different set of dimensions. Right. Velocity of light simply is an expression of the ratio of energy to mass.
All right, which is a limit.
A limit to what?
As a constant.
It's a constant,
yeah.
Not a limit. In the beam, Tesla found that he could transmit direct current energy over incredible distances. And this energy not diverging out of the beam, much tighter and more compact than any laser ever built. In the longitudinal mode through the ground, there is really no losses, and the light bulb would light up at the other end. Marconi, in an attempt to circumvent the Tesla patents, changed the impedance of the system and used the flat top antenna, where you would get transverse electromagnetic propagations at 186,000 miles per second and longitudinal magnetic dielectric transmissions at 291,000 miles per second. For those that want to go back through history, Professor Wheatstone proclaimed that the velocity of electrostatic induction was pi over 2 times the velocity of light. As those of you that know about electronics and electricity, I'm sure you've all heard of the Wheatstone Bridge. Wheatstone was a very important researcher. As things progressed, we ended up with this. Thanks to Mr. Sarnoff and RCA, all of these things were eliminated, and we ended up with a system where transmission only propagated at 180.
What I am doing. every single one of them. I see interferes with my efforts. Processes out, blocks out, flattens out. There's one thing or another, whatever it may be, to diminish, increase my efforts, not to diminish the effects of my efforts, to block out the sharpness and acuity of my thoughts, to reduce to rubble and nothing, or nothingness. What I have elaborated in about now 33 or 34 years of systematic thinking, and in about 40 years of human suffering since about 1912.
Men of goodwill and generosity should be able to unite regardless of party or politics. Goodwill and generosity should be able to unite regardless of party or politics. This nation was founded by men of many nations and backgrounds. It was founded on the principle that all men are created equal, and that the rights of every man are diminished when the rights of one man are threatened.
What is the location?
The check of voltage should be really high and it's not jogging.
What is the location? What is the location?
It's not jogged in.
By men of many nations and backgrounds. It was founded on the principle that all men are created equal, and that the rights of every man are diminished when the rights of one man are threatened. Men of goodwill.
You know, the reason why I'm making this video is because there's a lot of crap out there. A lot of deception. People basically keep stuff back, keep information back for themselves. People just don't understand.
Men of goodwill and generosity.
It works the way it really should
the
work.
Rights of one man.
And everyone's going to be very wealthy. They're going to be able to make material out of nothing. Metals, golds, foods, liquids, gases, light,
ban, threatened.
Heat,
threatened.
Everything you could
politics.
Live on.
Threatened. No politics. Man are diminished. Man are threatened. Are threatened.
I'm going to try and do it. I'm going to try and carefully change the voltage. I even jog it slightly.
Band are diminished. Band.
Voltage should be minus one.
Unthreatened. Politics. Unthreatened. Politics. Okay.
And the point I want to make is, I'm an honest and hard-working man. I've done the research into Eric Dollard and Nikola Tesla, Edward Leedskalnin. I've done my research into the periodic table, massive elements, Newtonian F1 and F2 forces. I've done my research into Galileo series. I've done my research and Tesla's oscillating current and impulse current. I've done my research in alternating current and direct current, and I've done my research in the envelopes of those waveforms. I've done my research on the Tesla magnifying transmitter. I've done my research on Wilhelm Reich and orgone energy. I've done my research on the proper dimensions of mutual inductance. L³, L². I've recreated a basic version of the Leedskalnin perpetual motion holder, and I've discovered that it can be used to create perpetual power as claimed by Edward Leedskalnin in magnetic current. And I've written a 350-page, 125,000-word book explaining how it can be done.
Fundamental units.
I write in my book how gravity of the moon motivates the trillions of watts, trillions and billions of watts of the sea to move. I write in my book that the red moon is when the moon is furthest away on the inactive side, on the side that it's not pulling, and the blue moon is on the active side, when it's in between the Sun and the Earth. So when the Moon is in between the Sun and the Earth, it pulls on the water on that side, but when it's on the far side, it's pushing. I write in my book about this, and I also cover much of Eric Dollard's history and life. I'll be donating 20% of all the proceeds of the book to Eric Dollard, because I feel very much that the man is deserving pretty much of all my possessions. I want to show you, this is not a trick. Power source. The only thing that's powering this is motion. Motion and geometry. If you move that just a millimeter, no more. It's that specific angle. It's that specific angle, no other angle. It doesn't matter how you hold this multimeter, it won't overreach that limit of the voltage. Research into Steinmetz. Now, you know, I explain in my book that I've never seen a working invention for negative resistance. I've never seen never seen an atom or an electron ever. Neither of the scientists. So I've gone to direct and ultra-direct means to prove magnetism can produce negative resistance. And as a result of that negative resistance, it produces voltage. And as we know, anything that has voltage, anything that has resistance, has current. This has no power connected to it. Where is the current coming from? See, many devices that are so-called working, but I've never seen one explained in a simple concept. What this device does is, once it's exposed to electricity, once in those coils, the lengthwise motion of the coils cause crosswise pull of magnets from the surrounding air. And as a result, pressure is set up where more comes in than get out. As a result, there's more electricity inside the U-bar, the transformer core, crosswise than there is lengthwise. Magnets dam up on the prongs. The result of this damming up is changing speed. Not that of light, but much slower. That better counts for negative resistance. It also accounts for the energy. Because once it starts moving, once this device becomes magnetized from the first time it's electrified, it actually is producing energy from that point. It only needs to be electrified once. And that's the advantage of this technology. This is, as you can see, the negative resistance and the negative voltage is only in small numbers. And you can see that the load of the DVM resistor, about the 100 ohm load of measuring the resistance, is having an effect. I've got an AVO, Ministry of Defense, like AVO Navy kind of, it's a good meter. It's AVO 8 Mark 5. It's analog and they use vacuum tubes, so I'll know for sure if this is really what it appears to be then. For anyone who's skeptical, you know, I just wanted to say 720 turns, this is a U-bolt axle. It doesn't matter which way you turn these, I recommend you turn them the same way, but the reason why it doesn't matter which way you turn them is because north is clockwise, south is anti-clockwise, so north or south can go around that coil clockwise or anti-clockwise. It's got nothing to do with the direction of the input current, because the input current is both poles, especially on this device, because it's fused south of primary to north of secondary, south of secondary to north of primary. Plus those two little barrels picking things up, just where I've connected the wires up. And as I said, you know, there's a lot of BS claims circulating around about, you know, working so-called free energy devices. This is a working device. At Coral Castle, Edward Leedskalnin had 120 of these. This can generate up to 0.4 volts. This is half as strong as one of Ed's devices, so one of Ed's devices can generate 1 volt, so 120 of them can generate about 120 volts and a considerable negative resistance in the 100 million ohm range. Thank you very much for watching this video. Please buy my book, Technology for a New Future. Thank you.
Put him on the price.